Welcome to part two of my Pete Cornish soft sustain two series of videos. As you might know, I recently got my Pete Cornish SS-2 pedal directly from Pete Cornish, and I also did an unboxing video and setup video onto my pedal board, and you can find it right here. And if you haven't watched it, go ahead and watch that if you want to see how it's been shipped and everything, and also how it went onto my board. Now it's time to do a short review of this pedal with some sound samples, as well as some different settings, as well as some Oasis and Noel Gallagher licks and bits and pieces of me playing guitar with Noel's exact settings. Now, first of all, this pedal alone will not get you the definitive Oasis sound. If you're unsatisfied with your sound, if you want to get closer to the Oasis sound, maybe this pedal is not for you. As you may know, Noel only uses it for... Now, not only, but Noel uses it for solos. 99% of the time, he uses it for the solos in High Flying Birds as well as Oasis. But sometimes he also uses it to... bit differently, which I'm trying to show you as well in this video. So maybe a bit of pedal buying advice. It's a Fuzz pedal, and I didn't buy this pedal only because of this Oasis and Noel Gallagher solo sound that I'm into. I like to play with Fuzz pedals, yeah, and I know that I'm using this pedal for more stuff than just Oasis and Noel Gallagher, since I'm quite into Fuzz pedals. Yeah, that's why I chose to make this kind of investment and acquire this fairly expensive pedal. Always buy pedals that you know you'll be using and you'll be having fun with, yeah, for most of the stuff you're trying to play on guitar. Not only for Oasis solos, for example. But that's only my opinion, of course. All right, let's jump right into the sound samples. And for the first few bits and pieces of me playing, I chose to use a Stratocaster, maybe show you some different styles of music you can play with that pedal as well. So let's go over the settings real quick, starting with the output. The output throughout this video is set to like in between 1 and 2 o'clock. That doesn't change. For the first sample you'll hear in a few seconds, I have set the tone to noon, as well as the sustain, kind of the gain part of the pedal, I have set also to 1 or 2 o'clock, yeah, which gives you a good mid-range Fuzz tone. So let's jump right into that sample. To respond well to the input you give on the guitar. For example, with fingerstyle playing that I like to do also, besides the Oasis stuff, it needs to just respond to the touch of my fingers on the strings. And this pedal does that really well. And for that sample, I have dialed back the sustain part a bit. It's now at like a quarter. Now let's hear how it responds to me playing the Stratocaster without a pick, but with fingerstyle playing. And for that, the first lick is a Mark Knopfler inspired lick, and the second lick is from John Mayer's adaptation of Crossroads. Thank you. right, let's have a little bit of fun. Let's take the sustain control and push it all the way to the max. I have this cranked now, it's at full. The sustain control, other controls are unchanged. Let's also add in a compressor, a delay, as well as the echo drive to push it a bit more. Fun, wasn't it? And now I'll be diving into the realm of Oasis and Noel Gallagher, and for that I'll be setting the pedal to the exact same settings as Noel Gallagher has it. And yeah, let's start with some Oasis solo licks. This is the outro solo of Slide Away. I have cut the backing track in the middle so you can also hear the guitar by itself without any backing track there. Play one of my favorite solos from Noel Gallagher's High Flying Birds, through this pedal, which is the solo from Lock All the Doors. Now, besides solos, Noel also likes to use this pedal for a kind of fuzzy sound that you'll hear him doing in Stop Crying Your Heart Out, for example. There he has like the gain pushed to the max with this pedal, and really sounds great. He also likes to use that for those kind of purposes as well. Similar fashion to Stop Crying Your Heart Out, Noel really likes to use this pedal also for generating noise and sound and having this wall of sound behind him for as kind of a stylistic element to his playing. And that's exactly what he does, for example, with the intro of Everybody's on the Run, because there with the intro part he also has the drum and timeline with the melt setting on, and he likes to just generate ton of sound, a wall of sound there. And for Everybody's on the Run, for the verse, for example, he switches that off. Yeah? He switches off the fast SS-2 pedal and he strums away for the verse, because then you can really hear also the pick attack on the string. Also in a similar kind of fashion to Everybody's on the Run, maybe not that drastic with this ton of fuzziness and gain and everything, he also does a song called Do the Damage. This was one of the opening tracks he had during the Chasing Yesterday tour. I think he also uses that when he got on stage, where he strummed his guitar without any volume on, and then he like slowly fades in the volume of the guitar, generating this massive sound. And then also switching the pedal off when he starts to do the first verse. And I think that's one other way he uses the pedal as well. If you want to hear more of this pedal as well as many other pedals I have, subscribe to my channel so you won't miss any videos. Yeah, I have a few guitar covers coming up as well. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions around this pedal or around other pedals I use, just post them in the comments. I'm always happy to engage with you guys. All right, see you in the next one.